Enforcer Mark D'Amato consistently manhandles Hot Dice Captain Mark Weber.
Mark Weber is a chump. I pull all the strings on all the puppets in my league.
And that has left Weber feeling ill.
I'm sick of D'Amato's old ass. His retirement plan goes in effect tonight.
But can Weber contain the most dangerous man on skates?
The only thing dangerous about D'Amato is the glare from his bald head.
D'Amato's not the only one looking to wipe out Weber and his X-Men.
X-Men, I'm putting the X in exterminate. And tonight, you guys are going down.
If Big Nasty gets his way, Weber will be X'd out. It's the Enforcers looking to roll the dice. Next on Roller Jam. Studios here in beautiful Orlando, Florida, and tonight we bring you Roller Jam as the Nevada Hot Dice get set to play the New York Enforcers. Tonight, that tough New York Enforcer team will find out just how tough, won't we, Hawk? I'm Rory Marcus, along with Lee Hawk Rearman, and tonight, Mark Weber continues his so-called retirement tour. He has somewhat excluded Mark D'Amato from that retirement tour, but I have a feeling tonight he's going to kick it into high gear because D'Amato just beat him up in Las Vegas.
Well, he's been talking about sending little Richard Brown to the showers, Sean Atkinson to the showers, everybody except Mark D'Amato. But the last time these guys were out, they threw all those niceties, if you could call them that, out the window. They went at it tooth and nail. I guess the friendship's off. I guess maybe that means the union's in disarray.
I don't think there ever was a friendship as far as Mark D'Amato's concerned. I don't know if he has any friends. Certainly Weber won't be a friend tonight. They're getting ready to skate onto the track. Let's take a look at the player introductions. There's the signal, and here we go. The signal is fireworks and fire on the walkway as they skate onto the track. The Nevada Hot Dice Women have to kind of duck under those flames sometimes, Hawk, but they're wondering if Shea Brown can have another big game on the women's side.
Well, she stepped up recently. She is emerging, and she's actually emerging in person right here. Kiss to the crowd. She is a whole new player just dominating the women's side of the ball here in the World Skating League, Rory.
She looks like she's in the mood tonight, too. And here come the men's team as Mark Weber will come out last. I think he has a whole new attitude where D'Amato is concerned, and he's going to be gunning for him.
Well, they say he's modeled himself in the image of Sean Atkins, and I think it's got a little bit of D'Amato, a little bit of Atkinson, maybe even a little bit of Richard Brown in him, but he would admit that.
I was wondering what he had in him. He's an odd-looking guy, isn't he? Here come the Enforcers, the Enforcer women, again without Karen Magnuson, out with an injury, and that means Janet Abraham, who injured Jamie Konimak recently, will have to continue to be tough out there.
You have to wonder what's going through her mind. She really stepped up when challenged by Mark D'Amato last game, Rory. But she went out of here with a little bit of a disheveled look on her face after she injured Jamie Konimak. Let's watch her performance early.
There's the Big Nasty, Tim Washington with his usual greeting before the audience.
You call that a greeting?
He has the chains around his neck. That means he's ready to go.
I think the other half of that tape said slippery when wet. Don't tell him I said that.
No, I won't. And there's D'Amato. We always know what to expect from the wonderful Mark D'Amato. Right now, Broadway Danny Wolf is in the infield with Mr. Mark Weber. Let's go to Danny.
All right, Mark, before many games, I've given you numerous opportunities to talk trash, to talk smack about Mark D'Amato, and you never have. Tonight, you said you have something to say.
Hey, Mark, where you at? Mark, tonight, I guarantee, buddy, this is your last game.
You mean retirement tour?
And your last game tonight.
Back to you, Rory and Hawk.
Roller Rules, brought to you by Dial 1-800-AT&T for collect calls.
There are 4 6-minute periods. The women skate periods 1 and 3. The men skate periods 2 and 4. There are 5 skaters per team, 2 jammers and 3 blockers. The blockers wear white helmets. The jammers have the black helmet with the stripe. Points are scored when jammers lap opposing team members. Here's an example of what I was just talking about. The jammer for the green team breaks out from the pack and circles the track. For each member of the red team that he or she passes, 1 point is earned.
Shea Brown's really emerging as an animal here in the World Skating League, Rory. Just thank Tink Miller, who was on the receiving end of that blow. And Janet Abraham, she really may be shaken up by that injury she inflicted on Jamie Conomac last time out. She has it in her, but look for her to be a little bit gun-shy here early.
It's the Enforcers and the Hot Dice. The women, of course, on the track first. And for the Enforcers, if you can't see a number on Courtney Barlow, either can I, but we don't need one for her. The black leather will do just fine, and she's out there leading this jam against Mindy Smith of the Nevada Hot Dice. And right now, they're the two lead jammers. Barlow for the Enforcers. There's a good look at the outfit, and the outfit just got a smudge on it. Mindy Smith continues on with the jam for the Hot Dice. Still plenty of time on this jam, a full 28 seconds. Katie Cooper comes back to lend a hand, and they get by April Tootle. Smith reaches Abraham and decides, I think I'll call it off now.
Two
Nevada points.
And apparently the Hot Dice are going to go with speed. Usually if they're going to go with a power game here, Rory, they might have sent like Laura Weintraub out on the first jam, maybe Shea Brown, but they sent Mindy Smith. They put the fastest bullet in the gun and they shot her right out of the chute and got some quick points.
2-0. The Hot Dice get on the board first. And here comes the second jam, and there is the gal you just mentioned, Laura Weintraub for the Nevada Hot Dice. And she creeps up on Christine Kassen. Both teams trying to get some early momentum here, and Kassen knocks her down. So that leaves Christine out there by herself.
And many people in the World Skating League are really just taking their hats off to the Enforcer women. The absence of Karen Magnuson has been picked up by many Enforcers, especially Big Janet Abraham. But they're a team that is still united. Pleasant surprise.
Shea Brown is back to block. Shea Brown is tough. She is not easy to go around. And Christine Costin's fighting that out, but it's a little easier when you get an assist like that. April Tootle caught Shea Brown napping and took her down. The Enforcers get 1 point.
Typical sister of suffering. They gang up on Shea Brown, and you see the result. She was enthusiastic. Now she's frustrated.
2-1 Hot Dice. We're back in a minute. Big Tim Washington waiting his turn, waiting for the second quarter to start so he can get out and start inflicting pain. That's something that's always good to look forward to. Adrian Medrano's out there for the New York Enforcers along with Christine Kassen. So New York gets two jammers out. Just one for the Hot Dice, number 37, Danielle Pendeline, who goes down. Now the Enforcers have two of them out there by themselves. Shea Brown goes back and says, huh, who's this coming up behind me? Medrano's not very big, and she pays the price. Now Shea Brown will work on Kassen. Shea Brown grabs Kassen by the helmet. And
oh, no.
Holds her down face first. Whoa, she's off to a big start in this game. You know, one thing we haven't seen, as April Tootle comes over to take up the fight with Brown, we haven't seen anything of Abraham.
Well, April Tootle came over to play enforcer, add a little muscle to try to combat Shea Brown after the fact, but Janet Abraham.
Look at this. D'Amato saying, where the heck are you? Get over there.
That's a good look at the Texas Bulldog. Look at the look on her face. You got to appreciate the enthusiasm. I mean, here in this day and age of marketing and money and showgirl sizzle, she just likes to have fun. Good for her.
Oh, that was great. They appreciate that back in North Carolina, where Shea is from. When we talked about Janet Abraham, she put Jamie Conomac in the hospital, and she's felt bad about it since then. And she has not come out here with the aggression that we have seen in past games.
Well, we talked about it a bunch, how she's a minister off the track, and she tries to do her best to, I guess, check her alter ego at the door when she comes in here, and apparently she's been kind of reassessing that activity after inflicting that injury on Jamie Conner, McElroy.
Courtney Barlow reassessing the jam after she gets knocked down, and there goes Lindy Smith. Boy, she's quick through that pack. She picked up a couple and called it off. Lindy Smith getting 2 points on the jam. That makes it 4-2, the hot dice lead. I understand Abraham went to try and visit Conomac and was turned away from the hospital. She wouldn't see her. And now D'Amato's right back in her face saying, what are you doing out there?
Well, that's 2 jams in a row she's been non-existent, and 2 jams in a row that Mark D'Amato has been on her case. And don't think these hot dice aren't aware of this controversy. That's why Mindy Smith is emerging with that big hole in the middle with a very docile Janet Abraham. Mindy Smith has taken full advantage, and the hot dice are the benefactor of this enforcer controversy.
Remember when Abraham hurt Conor Mac, D'Amato talked about how proud he was of her for doing it. Now he's not proud of her right now. He's upset with her, and he's put her on the bench. Courtney Barlow gets out there again for the enforcers. They're in black. That's all you need to know about that uniform. And Mindy Smith goes out for the hot dice. Boy, Mindy Smith has really turned into one of the best jammers in this league. She's given her team a 4-2. In fact, she has all 4 of the points, but she didn't get it that time as Courtney Barlow pushes her into the pack. The lift works again, and the enforcers get the point.
Well, noticeably absent from that lift, Rory, was Janet Abraham. D'Amato sat her down, puts in some new blood. Mindy Smith, who's having a great first period up to this point, sees Courtney Barlow go by and pick up a bunch of points.
But the men are coming up next. There's Mark Weber with a smile on his face and something in his tongue. He'll be going up against the New York Enforcers and Mark D'Amato. He looks pleased with himself. Stay with us. It's 2-1 Dice. We're back in Orlando, the World Skating League and Roller Jam. Broadway Danny Wolf is in the infield with a subdued Janet Abraham.
Yeah, very subdued. Not the Janet Abraham we're used to usually seeing. I mean, with Karen Magnussen out, you're supposed to be the leader out there, and you've looked quite timid out there, to say the least. You're even ignoring Mark D'Amato's instructions.
I'm not going to let Mark D'Amato turn me into a monster, okay?
I hear you. Thank you, Janet. Back to you, Rory and Hawk.
Janet Abraham, I don't know what you expect from that man. He is a monster. Of course, he's going to try to craft you in his image. And monstrous is that move going against some of the riot. And he'll go up against Mark Weber. He's got a big mouth, but he also has a lot of energy, a lot of enthusiasm, and, of course, a lot of athletic ability.
All right, we're ready to go into period number 2. The men are on the track, and there they go with the first jam of period number 2. It's Jason McDaniel out there against Freddie Icor, number 16 for the New York Enforcers.
Down goes McDaniel. Wow.
Fred Icorn has a chance to score some points, and now he meets up with his spiritual leader, D'Amato, who knocks flat number 36, Jason McDaniel. And now there goes D'Amato in his typical style, just blowing the pack apart. Takes Micah Martin down, and the enforcers got a whole bunch of them. They pick up 4, and D'Amato's right in the groove the moment he steps on the track.
Right out of the chute, the enforcers just bring out the 5-4-0 lineup. This jam was ugly from top to bottom. It wasn't pretty. Nobody really broke out and showcased any kind of finesse. It was just bloody nose. I guess, I don't want to say rear ends and elbows, but that was Mark D'Amato's 5-4-0 lineup. But hey, they got a bunch of points, got them quick, and they're out to a big lead, Rory.
They lead it 10-4 as Rocky Bowman streaks out of the pack. And after him, there goes Micah Martin. Two guys with pretty good speed right here. A little dipsy doodle move sends Micah Martin down. Well, he skated across the infield to get back at him. He's even with him, but he went right across the infield. And now D'Amato says, go ahead, Rocky. I'll take care of Micah. That won't take too long. They cut the legs out from underneath Mark Weber that time. Washington, D'Amato, Rocky Bowman, they're right back at it. Back to their old tricks again. But it's paying off on the scoreboard for the enforcers. Here's Bowman looking for more, and he made Weber miss. He slipped underneath Jason McDaniel. Weber tumbles over him. Bowman's making him look silly. The whistle sounds, the jam is over, but the enforcers did a tremendous job on that jam.
If the last jam was enforcer power, this jam was the Rock finesse. We saw last jam, it was just smash mouth roller jam. Well, this is the Rocky Bowman show. You see, Rocky Bowman goes down. Everybody goes down, but he was just making mincemeat out of the X-Men. Hey, he's playing their game. What's he trying to get away with, The Rock?
So the Enforcers were the only ones to get points, and they lead it by 9 here in the second quarter. That's a big early lead. D'Amato turns and gives a whip.
And if Janet Abraham was absent from the Enforcer women, where's Mark Weber been? He threatened to end Mark D'Amato, and Mark D'Amato just kind of shrugged it off with a giggle. Well, Mark D'Amato's enforcers have said, hey, Mark Weber, you better keep your mouth shut and play ball, and he hadn't done either.
It sure doesn't look like the last game D'Amato will ever skate, does it? By the way, Sean Atkinson has asked him to officially change his name to D'Amato, but I don't think he's going to do it. He is blocking against Jason McDaniel. He gives McDaniel a couple of shots. McDaniel, one of the better skaters in this league, and D'Amato's really working him. He's working him over. D'Amato still got him. Oh! Who were you just talking about? Mark Weber? There he is.
It's the screamer. Hey, Rory, I never claim to know anything. I know three things. I'm going to die. I got to pay a lot of taxes. And Mark D'Amato's an ugly dude. But the fourth that was something I didn't know it was that Weber showed up a little late, but he showed up and even stole one of Mark D'Amato's moves. They call it the screamer. Usually the recipient is getting a face full of Mark D'Amato crotch. Well, on this case, hey, Mark D'Amato, here's a taste of your own medicine. The retirement tour ends with a little Mark Weber crotch. How's it taste, buddy? Kaboom.
13-5. The Enforcers lead this game. D'Amato's still skating, though. He's not going to retire. You kidding me? This guy lives for this stuff. Sean Davidson, the big guy, number 39. You don't see him jam very often, but he did it nicely there.
Well, look at the size of this guy, Rory. He's the only skater in the World Skating League that needs 5 wheels for his skates. The kid wears a size 17 shoe. You know what that means.
Yeah.
I know what it means. It means he's out there jamming, and he looks like a runaway freight train. That's what it means.
They brought him in here in a wheelbarrow today. And now D'Amato is trying to send him back. Davidson, huge guy. But oh, speaking of big guys, one of these days his head's going to explode.
I think his head already exploded a long time ago. There it is. There's the repercussions from the explosion.
It just landed back on his neck.
That was a King Kong. We're singing the praises of big number 39, Sean Davidson, just in time to get people to watch him. Oh, man.
Oh, that's like a football hit. Here's Florida against Florida State. 13-5 Enforcers, and my goodness, does the Big Nasty like that. He loves it.
Well, my mom had me on a short leash, Rory. I keep telling you, every time they flash one of those Tim Washington ISO slow motion shots, she leaves me a message saying I can't come back next week. I have to talk her back into it. I don't know about this one, though. That was really ugly.
Did you see Christian Salvia go into that rail ribs first? And you know what? The Cuban missile bounces back up and chases Fred Eichhorn on the jam. 13-5, the Enforcers lead this game. This is the final jam of the first half. Can Eichhorn get him? Yeah, he knocked him down again.
Tough jam for the Cuban missile.
You're not kidding. I hope Castro's not here or he's in trouble. The Enforcers have been so bad this quarter, so bad that they're good.
Well, and Weber, 2 jams ago, we were all talking about him stealing the screamer and giving it to Mark D'Amato. What's Logue doing?
Here he comes.
I think he enjoyed the screamer to D'Amato, but 2 jams in a row, Tim Washington, the Big Nasty, brings out the King Kong on Sean Davidson, almost ends his career. And Mark D'Amato just wreaks havoc with the help of Tim Washington. Hey, Mark Weber, that screamer, I think, just made him mad. And Jason McDaniel, you just got lost in the way.
We're at halftime. D'Amato's happy. Washington's happy. The Enforcers lead 15-5. Don't go away. You're looking at Roller Jam Arena, the World Skating League in Roller Jam. That's what this is, and we are at halftime. Rory Marcus and Lee Hawk Rearman, the New York Enforcers, and the Nevada Hot Dice. You know, normally we would talk about nothing but highlights, but really almost a non-highlight in the first half. Janet Abraham's refusal to be aggressive at all, much to the chagrin of Mr. Mark D'Amato.
After the first period, Janet Abraham said that Mark D'Amato was trying to create her into a monster. Well, she tried to exorcise the beast from herself. It couldn't have happened at a worse time, but Tim Washington picked it up for the men, and of course, Mark D'Amato adds a little bit to the X-Men's woes, but Mark Weber here at the end of the second period really got it together and lays the screamer on an unsuspecting Mark D'Amato.
Bite down hard now, because here comes Rail Bites featuring Mark Weber.
Woo! Come on, can you feel it?
D'Amato shaking hands with the fans. I don't know who'd want to shake his hand, but Broadway Danny Wolf's in the infield with Kenneth Logue.
Well, you know what, with Kenneth Logue, he always has some interesting comments. We saw you working the Sundog team, the new look Sundogs, hard workouts, vigorous training. They almost skated one game, and then you pulled them out at the last second. When will they debut already, Kenneth?
Very soon, Daniel, very soon. I'm really looking forward to introducing the fans to the new look Sundogs. They skate clean, but they skate hard.
Well, clean and hard doesn't always win games in the World Skating League, Kenneth.
Clean and hard worked for the golden age of roller derby. I'm sure it'll work again now.
Now also, you were ranting and raving earlier about Mark D'Amato. You got something on Mark D'Amato. Well, spill the beans. I'm sure we'd all like to hear what it is.
We have just completed an internal audit of the finances of the World Skating League, and our auditors have discovered that about $400,000 is missing from the Skaters Pension Fund, which is a fund that was controlled directly by Mr. D'Amato and his business manager.
Are you accusing Mark D'Amato of siphoning out, stealing from the pension fund? That's almost $500,000, Kenneth. Those are serious accusations.
And believe me, Daniel, I would never besmirch anyone's reputation, even Mark D'Amato's, without being very sure of my facts. We passed the evidence on to the Justice Department and the FBI. What happens now is up to them.
Well, thank you, Kenneth, and you better bet in the second half I'm going to get Mark D'Amato. I'm going to capture him, bring him over here, and ask him about this accusation you made. That's a lot of money you're talking about him taking. Right now, let's go back to Rory and Hawk.
Can you imagine the FBI picking up the phone, and it was Kenneth Logue? But he has made some real accusations against Mark D'Amato. Let's put that aside for a minute and get ready for the second half. Shay Brown, she has a pretty smile for somebody so tough. She'll be going up against Janet Abraham of the New York Enforcers. How tough will she want to be? Will she do what D'Amato told her to do? We'll find out. The second half is coming up. Stay with us. We're back in Orlando. Roller Jam getting ready to go into the second half, and we're fired up for it. I hope you are too. It's the Enforcers and the Hot Dice, and it's 15-5 New York.
Now, wait a minute. That was where you guys were trying to get me to sit at halftime, you and the crew. Now I get it.
That's right.
Wow.
Remember we told you to lay out? That's what we meant. Lay down over there.
I thought D'Amato was somebody I had to watch out for. I got to watch out for Rory Marcus, my partner up here.
And the jam is underway as Courtney Barlow gets out there against Laura Weintraub. Courtney Barlow in the black of the New York Enforcers. That's my favorite uniform in this league. And she looks great in it as Weintraub tries to get by her and pick up some points for the Hot Dice. They need them. They're down 10. The move missed. It did trip Barlow up. Katie Cooper. Cooper.
One black.
Tried to get in there and knock Barlow down, but instead Courtney gets the only point in that jam.
You see Laura Weintraub and Barlow coming up to the back of the pack. Katie Cooper throws an almost air ball.
That looked like a Shaq free throw. He missed everything. And there's Janet Abraham. Benched by D'Amato. He says, you sit there. You know what? I have to admit, he's got a point because she's doing nothing in this game. She's been a big gun for this team for a long time. But since injuring Konamak, it's almost as though her heart's not in it. There goes Mindy Smith for the Hot Dice, who trail this game 16-5. Not quite out of it yet, but in danger of getting that way. Mindy Smith needs to pick up some points, and she's going to get Shea Brown and enlist her help. But Shea missed the block on April Tootle, and Tootle's able to keep Mindy Smith away. 15 seconds remaining in the jam. Boy, somebody flew out of that pack. That was Faith Urban. As the Hot Dice pick up a couple, maybe two or three. We'll see what the referees give them.
Three white.
Three, says Shar Corbin. Three Hot Dice points.
Shea Brown and Mindy Smith are really developing into a 1-2 punch. Shea Brown and Mindy Smith are just quite a tandem that are emerging as a powerhouse for the skating world.
16-8, the Enforcers have doubled up the score of the Hot Dice. And guess who's out there again? That's right, Mindy Smith. And here comes Adrian Medrano. Every now and then they'll send Adrian Medrano out there. I don't think I've ever seen her score a point. And I'm still waiting. She gives it her all, though. She's only about 4'11". And here comes Mindy Smith. For the Hot Dice, trying to get him even closer here in this third period. Oh, she was right by Courtney Barlow. Now gets another one. Good skating by Mindy Smith. Let's see if Abraham does anything. She's basically just standing there. Smith gets by Barlow again and again and again. And now it's just Abraham and Mindy Smith. What will she do? That's kind of a mild block. Abraham now kept her from scoring another one. Mindy Smith calls it off. And look at this. Here comes D'Amato onto the track. Mark D'Amato's after his own skater, I think.
Well, Abraham on that jam had ample opportunity to just
look at this, look
annihilate
at
Mindy Smith. And now he grabs Mindy Smith, that's Mark D'Amato, and challenges Janet Abraham to do what he thought she should have done last jam. See if this is just an outburst or a finality or a final chapter to this broken relationship.
That's the hardest Janet Abraham's hit anybody all night. And I think, as I said before, her heart's just not in it, and she's leaving the track. She said, you can't make me do anything. And she's gone. And the demonic presence of D'Amato, of Mark D'Amato, lives on here in the World Skating League.
Well, you can't blame either of them. It's obvious that her heart's not in it. She's not performing like she should for her teammates. But Mark D'Amato, you know, he can't ignore that. But on the other hand, side of the coin, she's really broken up about this injury to Jamie Konamak, so you have to be sensitive to her position.
I don't think I've ever seen one of the men come out, grab one of the women, and set her up to get hit by another woman. But that's what D'Amato was trying to do. And when Janet Abraham didn't respond, he pretty much fired her on the spot.
And what a gaping wound in this enforcer lineup for the women. They have no one. Magnuson's out. Now Janet Abraham has left the track. We'll see if it's for a few moments or for good.
Let's see if Medrano can get a point. She's up there on the jam. She's trying to get by Katie Cooper. She sneaks by up on top. She got something there before going to the rail, and the little one says, hey, I can jam.
Three black.
She got three. Way to go, Adrian Medrano.
You said it earlier, it doesn't take much to stop her, so once she gets contact with somebody, she's immediately out of scoring position. But right there, Royce, he's got to snuck around him. I think everybody here is stunned that Janet Abraham has been kicked out of the arena, off the team, and perhaps out of New York by Mark D'Amato.
Look at D'Amato. Does that look like a man that has $400,000 in his pocket? As Dolly Parton once said, it costs a lot of money to look this cheap. 19-10, the Enforcers lead it by 9.
Well, we know both places her $400,000 went up.
There goes Shea Brown. She doesn't have the helmet on, but she's out of the jam anyway. She's got plenty of black hair flowing, so we'll let it go at that. April Tootle chases for the Enforcers. This is the final jam of the women's period. And Brown has been passed now. Katie Cooper back there in the back of the pack for the hot dice. Shea Brown goes down. Tootle knocked her down. And now it's Tootle who's picking up some points as Andrea Franklin goes into the rail. And Katie Cooper still trying to keep her back. But she's scored at least one so far. 15 seconds left on the jam. Brown trying to catch from behind. Tootle gets another one. And calls it off. That was a wise move. Coming up, the final period of this game. Mark Weber looking to retire Mark D'Amato. And maybe he feels like quitting after what's been going on with Janet Abraham, who has quit herself from this team. But D'Amato will come out now and try and win this game and worry about that later. The Enforcers lead it by 10. We're back in Roller Jam Arena. The story tonight has been Mark D'Amato. Is he stealing money? Has he fired Janet Abraham? He has his hand in Danny Wolf's pocket. Go ahead, Broadway.
Well, he got it's not in my pocket yet. Mark D'Amato, I can't believe Janet Abraham quit the New York Enforcers.
Quit? You freaking idiot. Did you see what happened? I fired her. I asked her to do one thing, to step in for the injured Karen Magnuson, and she was not up to the job. She willfully disobeyed me.
Yeah, but she was your best blocker.
She was, Wolf. She was. She's only a memory.
Unbelievable. Back to you, Rory and Hawk.
Probably the last time we'll see Janet Abraham in a New York Enforcer uniform, and the crowd reacts to D'Amato.
I'm reacting the same way to D'Amato, but my thumb just went up when I reacted to the ring girl. Woo-wee.
You change your mind a lot, just in the blink of an eye, from sad to mad to happy.
I change like the wind, my brother.
John Morrissey goes out for the New York Enforcers. This is the final period of the game, and the Enforcers have a big lead here, 21-11. Christian Salvi is out there for the Nevada Hot Dice. The problem for the Hot Dice, oh, look at the pack way down. Salvi leaps over the top and calls it off in midair. And that's the Cuban missile we've come to know.
And a heads-up play. We saw him do it before. He actually didn't have to. As Mark D'Amato plays a little, I guess Salvia's playing a little cat and mouse. Hey, Mark
sure
D'Amato,
is.
You're making yourself look foolish, my friend. Come on, you got quad skates.
Let's go.
You can't keep up with these young cats. But Salvia, he wasn't certain that the skull, Morrissey, wasn't in hot pursuit. So when he goes over, he realizes he wants the points, but he doesn't want to sacrifice the points for the opponent, calls off the jam. What a heads-up play.
The Enforcers by 6. We're here in the final period of this one. And there goes number 14, J.R. Widener, for the Enforcers. Who's chasing him? Micah Martin. Wow, there's a whack to the back of the head to take Carol Widener. And Micah Martin gets on those fast skates. But the problem is, when he gets to the back of the pack, guess who?
And Mark Weber, once again, Rory, he talked a whole good game. Before the game, he talked the talk, but he has not walked the walk so far in this Enforcer matchup.
He claimed this would be D'Amato's last game. I don't think so.
It might be Micah Martin's last game, if this is any indication the way it's starting right here.
Could be his last moments on Earth every time you hook up with Tim Washington. I've never seen a guy take more pleasure out of hurting people. Look at him laugh and smile about it while a man crawls away.
That's all that matters. Keep moving.
Well, you know when Tim Washington skates backward, you hear that beep, beep, beep sound. I bet Micah Martin was wishing he was skating away from him right here. That cannot feel good. And Tim Washington always makes his presence known right at the back of that pack, Rory. You can think you're coming up to score some points. You can get a good shot on J.R. Widener to come up to the back of the pack, but when you know Tim Washington is standing there waiting for you, what a rude awakening that's got to be.
Oh, is this guy strong or what? The ice cream man went by, I saw him run right through a concrete wall. 21-16, Enforcers by five. Both the Jammers get nailed into the rail, but McDaniel gets the worst of it. And that leaves Rocky Bowman. Rocky Bowman is emerging, don't you think, as a star in this league?
Well, you see why. Look at the skating style he's got, Rory. Similar to what Jason McDaniel can do, similar to what Micah Martin can do. This kid really adds a whole new element to that five-borough lineup because he's so fast. Just watch him move.
Jason McDaniel trying to keep Bowman away. The Hot Knights, no, they're down by five right here. Now McDaniel's got a hold of him, and Weber's waiting. Oh, no! Head over heel, off the track, and out of the building just about. Now, there go D'Amato and Weber at it. He's holding his knee. Let's hope he's not hurt. But D'Amato and Weber are embroiled in another fight.
All right, that's enough. Break.
We'll be back. It's 22-16. The New York Enforcers by six. We'll decide this thing when we return. Hey, there's Christian Salvia. So let's take a look at our Army Men air attack of the game. And it is Christian Salvia sailing over the pack and calling off the jam in midair. So the Cuban Missile is our Army Men air attack of the game.
Come on, you guys!
Courtney Barlow and the Enforcer women watching from the infield. They're all standing. They're on their feet as we get ready to decide this game. 22-16 with a couple of minutes left. The Enforcers by six. D'Amato's been in a bad mood all night. I'd hate to see him if they lose this game.
D'Amato's been in a bad mood since he was born, Rory. I don't think a guy like Mark D'Amato is born. I think he's like a chemistry experiment gone awry from like the late 50s.
Well, he was happy that we decided to do these games in Florida because then he could sleep in the swamp. J.R. Widener's out there for the New York Enforcers, and Micah Martin sends Widener over. That's Fred Eichhorn, rather, up and over the rail. Nice play by Micah Martin, but now look what they have to contend with. Weber thinks he can get him through D'Amato and Washington. Let's see if he can. Weber flies through the air and pulls them both down. Micah Martin got two. He got three. He's going to try and get four, but he could not quite get by Eichhorn that time. Three Hot Knights points.
And you got to take your hat off to Weber. The last jam, he gave a modified roll them bones to the rock, and right here he takes down the double block of D'Amato and Washington. It usually takes an act of Congress to bring those two guys down. I tell you, Rory, I was making a little fun of him that he can talk the talk and not walk the walk. Well, he just gave his bark some bite here when it counts, and Micah Martin scores the points and brings these Hot Dice back in a hurry. Hey, Weber may just emerge as a true leader both in the mouth department and in the play department.
Washington had to bite his tongue because he didn't want to get sent to the penalty box for the last jam of the game. With the score 22-19, the Enforcers lead. And as two jammers go down, Weber gives a whip to Christian Salvia, and he is by himself with a chance to win the game. 22-19. Right. The Dice are concerned not only about the health of their teammates, but they lost the game. Where's that chain been this entire game? I can't believe he brought that thing out here. The enforcers have won another one. And they do it any way they possibly can. They're actually being booed out here tonight. Well, there's just no getting through this.
This is the Wall Street. You got the five furrow lineup. And Christian Salvia looks like the Staten Island Ferry coming into port down there by the Statue of Liberty in Lower Manhattan. And a little bit later, you see Mark Weber show up. The game's over. He's lost. But Tim Washington and Mark D'Amato are not done with him yet. Once again, the words of Mark Weber just makes these guys mad, and the result is both a loss and a lot of pain.
What a game victory by the New York Enforcers. First, Mark Weber before the game said this was going to be your retirement game. Yeah, you're laughing. I got to tell you, you guys weren't really going at each other as much as I thought earlier in the game, but then to break out a chain at the end, oh my, Mark.
Let me tell you something. Age and treachery will always outdo youth and enthusiasm.
Now, let's also talk about Janet Abraham. You fired her during this game. Obviously, you're going to have to get someone to replace
her. Get rid of her. She did not perform up to enforcing standards, and she's gone. She's out of a job.
And Mark, I'm going to get to you in a second about the allegations from Kenneth Lowe, but Big Tim Washington, great performance by you. The enforcers hadn't been skating like the old enforcers.
Oh, come on now, Danny. You saw us out there. You know when we get to these guys, everyone saw that. You're going to check it out. It's over. We blasted them.
Well, Mark D'Amato, lastly, Kenneth Lowe III at halftime made some allegations about you skimming a large amount of money. We're talking about $400,000 out of the pension fund. Any truth to this?
These claims are absolutely ridiculous. My reputation anywhere, including the WSL, is spotless. I am the highest paid salary. I don't need $40,000. That's pocket change to me. And not only that, I'm a philanthropist. Everyone knows of my charity work.
Spotless charity work. Spotless, that's $400,000.
A lot of work for such charities as Cigarettes on Wheels.
Cigarettes on Wheels?
Yeah, that's right.
Well, that's, we're talking $400,000, Mark D'Amato. That is a big hunk of change.
I'm telling you, this Logue is desperate. He's doing everything he can to discredit me.
Well, that's Mark D'Amato's story, and I guess he's sticking to it. Right now, let's go back to Rory and Hawk.
One of the all-time great charities, Hawk, Cigarettes on Wheels.
Mark D'Amato is an absolute mess, and the relationship with him and Janet Abraham is definitely hell on wheels, though.
I'd like to know where that $400,000 are, as there is Courtney Barlow saying we're number one. Yes, you beat the Hot Dyes tonight. New York wins the game 22-19. Say goodnight to Jason McDaniel right there, and to the enforcers, and to the Hot Dyes, and to you. Thanks for joining us, Big Nasty. On Roller Jam, we'll see you next time.